Perfect timing. I was just getting all my supplies out to start this Grisaille painting.
Come on in.
You know, a Grisaille painting is primarily a monochromatic black and gray and white painting. It's used usually for an underpainting to set the stage and the values for a color painting. But if you leave it as a standalone, it can be a very powerful piece. Come on, I'll show you. That is fascinating stuff. To start our own Grisaille, we're going to need some supplies first. As a traditionalist, I like to stretch my own canvas. But of course, knowing that budgets are a constraint, a teacher has the freedom, so to speak, to use any kind of canvas for their classroom. It could be pre-made, it could be a canvas board, it could even be panels that have been gessoed. Whatever's easiest for you and your classroom, you can make do. I'm going to start by stretching my own and then priming it with gesso. Once I have the pieces put together, I square it up, usually in a doorway or with a T-square, and then with just one staple in each corner, I solidify that so that it doesn't shift. Now I'm going to wrap the canvas around and staple it all together. Now that I've got my canvas stretched, this is unprimed, which means then I have to prime it with gesso. So what I'm going to do is one coat, I'm going to let it dry, and then once that's dry, that first coat's going to get lightly sanded with sandpaper, and then I'm going to do a second coat, let that dry, do another nice light sanding coat, and then I'm ready to start painting. As with most of my other lessons and other units, this is highly adaptable based on your situation in your own classroom. You can have students, in terms of subject matter, work from still life references. They can bring in objects for themselves. You can set objects up for them. Or if you're kind of cut for time and you don't have enough space to set up something, you can always work from reference photographs. Okay? In this case, I have my black and white already pre-printed and ready to go. So I'm going to use this as the reference to draw onto my primed canvas.
My initial step with painting is only going to be using black. I'm going to set my undervalues in almost a wash approach. And then I'm going to glaze the white on later on after everything's dry. So first thing I'm going to do is set up my black paint.
Now I'm going to start painting with black, and again, I said I'm going to use a wash first. So you want to keep the painting flat, okay? That's very important so that the wash doesn't eventually run and drip. Using my reference, I am going to put my black tones in first, the darkest, and then I'm going to wash out from that darkest point and set my tones that way. Notice how I'm pulling the area that I previously painted so that it gets thinner and lighter progressively. Notice how I'm going to take that and pull that black out so that it gets thinner and lighter.
So now that I have my underpainting done and dry in this particular section, now it's time to add the midtones and the highlights. And we do that with Artist Acrylic Glazing Medium. What this does is it allows you to control the opacity of the white when you apply it. The higher the opacity, the lower chance you have of seeing the underpainting show through. So this is good for our bright white highlights. And then when we go into our midtones, we add a little bit more glaze so that it becomes more transparent, allowing the underpainting to show through. And we have greater control of our values when we paint in this fashion. So now the next step is to add my palette with white and the glazing medium. So I'm going to start with my midtones first by mixing in the glazing medium with the white. And what I'm going to do is I'm going to use it to kind of unify that underpainting, that gestural kind of look, and kind of smooth everything out. Starting with just a little bit and then mixing it in with the white, I'm going to then start to, using my reference of course, I'm going to start to then place my midtones right on top so that it kind of softens out and makes it nice and uniform. Again, the more I want that underpainting to show through, the more glaze I'm going to add to that paint. For pure highlight areas, you may not need any glaze at all. It might just be pure white, and we'll do that as well. Let's try a little bit of the pure white, wherever my highlight is, and then just add that right on top in that spot, just like that. And then go back in again with my glaze and my midtone and pull that all together so that it finishes it off and gives a nice uniform painting. Gotta love it. As with all the other units in the ASA instructional video series, this one is completely modifiable. You can adapt it to your grade level, to your room situation, to the talent level in your class. So keep in mind that all of these things can be changed and adapted according to your individual taste and your teaching abilities. Thanks so much again for coming to spend some time here at Lindbergh High School. Hope to see you again real soon. I'm Tom Senna for Lindbergh High School Art Department. Thanks for stopping by. shooting? I'm gonna set my values with only the black paint right now. The white can come later on when we glaze it in. So right now, all you need is the black paint, and we're gonna do actually kind of like a... need is the black paint, our brushes, water, paper towel, and magazine palette.
Wait, what do you want me to do?
Don't stop. Don't leave. When you start saying black paint, I'm starting to pan down.
But you weren't panning down.
But I didn't know what you were waiting.
I'm going to initially set my undervalued tones with only black. The white's going to come later on when we glaze it, okay? So right now, all I need is black paint, water, my brushes, paper towel, and my magazine.
What are you doing?
So that now that I have... So now that I have a sizable part of the underpainting completed and dry, which is very, very important, it has to be dry before we start the next step. Now we can... So now I have to set up my palette, and all I need is white and the glazing. Important for this next step, we can add our midtones and our highlights with the white. And to do that, we're going to use glazing medium for acrylic. What this does is it allows us to control the opacity of the white. If we want more of the...
I can't control my zoom on this thing.